Hopefully, till now you are understanding that how difficult some of these concepts are, because in class 11th there are concepts which we can easily relate to our common life, but in class 12th concepts are quite difficult which we are not able to see in our real life. Hence these concepts are quite difficult. So please focus on these concepts and understand them very clearly. Okay, so there was an equation 1.8 which was simply that Coulomb force is just a multiplication of electric field with the charge placed in it, or we can simply say that the field is always there. As soon as we put another charge into that field starts acting as a force on that charge. Okay, so there are some important remarks. So first is that from equation 1.8 we can infer that Q is unity. If Q, let us say, if Q is unity, the electric field due to a charge Q is numerically equal to force exerted, that is always there. So if Q is unity 1, so F is equal to E. So both force and this field are numerically equal. Thus electric field due to a charge, there is the definition. Thus the electric field due to charge Q at a point in space may be defined as the force that a unit positive charge would experience if placed inside this field. If we place inside at a point, okay? Oh. So this is the force that a positive charge, single unit or unit positive charge feels when we place that charge into this field. Okay, let us see another thing. So first let me take this rubber, erase this. So please note down this definition. The electric field due to a charge capital Q at a point in space, so let us say any point, whether that is 1 meter far, 2 meter far or more than that, because in both we are dividing by distance square, so that will cancel out. So thus the electric field due to a charge capital Q at a point in space may be defined as the force that a unit positive charge, this is important, you must write this a unit positive charge, this is not on a unit negative charge, this is always on a unit positive charge. You define a field always on a unit positive charge. So this is on unit positive charge experience, would experience if placed at that point. If we put a unit positive charge at point P, how much force that unit positive charge experience, that is called the electric field. The charge Q is producing the electric field. Okay, the capital Q charge is producing electric field is called source charge, and the charge small q which tests the effect of source charge is called test charge. So there are this test charge, this test charge small q is test charge, and this capital Q is the producing the electric field which is called source charge. So there are two type of charges, source charge and test charge. Now we see that however, if a charge Q is brought in any point around Q, Q itself is bound to experience an electric force due to Q will tend to move. Definitely this capital Q will also experience a force due to this small Q. A way out of this difficulty is to make Q negligibly small. So what they are trying to say that if we bring a small charge Q closer to this, so the capital Q will remove from its position because of this repulsive force, because of repulsive or attractive force. There may be repulsive as well as attractive force. So how can we measure this field? How can we measure field? So there is only one way to measure this field, that we make Q very 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 small, or we can say negligibly small. So let us understand this. Suppose a charge capital Q is here, So it is radiating in all direction, in this, this, in all direction, okay. So as soon we bring a charge, positive charge, unit positive charge Q, and when this positive Q charge is there, so definitely there is a force of repulsion, so it will displace this charge, it will displace from its original position. So again, so how can we calculate this electric field, or how can we measure this electric field? So one way is, if Q is very small, Q tends to zero, that means Q is very small, then we can define this. The force F is then negligibly small, but the ratio of F by Q is finite. So if charge Q is very small, definitely force is very small, so capital Q will not move much, but the ratio of this F by Q will remain same. So in this way we are able to define this electric field. So this is one way of defining the electric field. In reality, what we do in reality, a practical way to get around the problem of keeping Q undisturbed in presence of Q is to hold Q to its location by unspecified forces. So in real life, what we do, we hold Q to its location by unspecified forces. So this may look strange, but actually this is what happens in practice. So in real life, what we do, so we put a charge, let us say we put this charge and nut bolt, with the help of nut bolt we tighten it to a fixed place, so it will not move. So in a way we are able to measure the electric field. This may look strange, but actually this is what happens in practice. We are considering the electric force on a test charge small q due to a charge planar sheet. The charges of the sheet are held to their location by force due to unspecified charge constituents inside the sheet. Another way is that if we take planar sheet which is charged, so the charges inside that sheet will not be able to move because of the unspecified forces due to unspecified charges constituents inside the sheet. Now second point. Note that electric field E, again this is a vector quantity, due to Q, though defined operationally in terms of some test charge, is independent of Q. This is again very important. We are able to measure this field only in presence of Q, but it is not dependent on Q. It is independent of Q. This is because force is proportional to Q, so the ratio F upon Q does not depend on Q. So here what we are seeing, that F by Q ratio, force is proportional to Q, so F by Q ratio remains the same, but field will not depend, field is not dependent on this small Q. The force F on the charge Q due to charge Q depends on the particular location of charge Q, which may take any value in space around charge Q. So again, this for the same for the distance, so we can take any point, but as the force is reduced, so the electric field, because in the both of them there is a proportionality 1 by r square. Thus the electric field E due to Q is also dependent on the space coordinate r. Yes, it is dependent on space coordinate r for different position of charge Q all over the space. We get different values of electric field. The field exists at every point in three-dimensional space. So this is difficult to understand, but let us say if we lit a candle, so it will produce some light in all the direction in 3D. Similarly, if we put a test charge or source charge capital Q, it will produce electric field similar to light in all the direction, three direction. And as we see in case of light, as we move away from this candle, the light is less and less, and if we move further, light becomes much less. Similarly, this electric field becomes less and less as we move far and far from this source charge. So electric field is dependent on this distance.